young boys that ran up in front of the Myers house when Loomis and the deputy sheriff were out there, and they started asking about Bennett Tramer and this funny mask he was wearing. And he was that character, and then Lance was the boombox boy. Yeah. He had the boombox boy, the boombox on his shoulder with the little cowboy hat on.
And it's kind of funny now because he being the boombox boy and now already doing movie music now all of a sudden.
Yeah, he is. I think he would love to do the theme music for the next Halloween.
Yeah.
We'll see. He does have a number of musical pieces that he did in the new 25 Years of Terror DVD that Anchor Bay put out.
Yeah. And I've been to his website just like I've been to your website, so it's all kind of neat. All kind of separates each other, kind of.
Yeah. Have you been to Billy Warlock's website?
To be honest with you, I looked up a little information about your son Billy. I guess on InternetMovieDatabase.com, and I guess he was a part of the Baywatch series and all that. And
He's been there the first 2 years.
Okay. Yeah, I'll be honest. I don't really know a whole lot about the whole Warlock family. I just I'll mention, Michael Strider, just the kind of helped me get to you in the first place, but then I went to your website and emailed you, and that's how why we're doing the interview today.
And Michael Strider's a dear friend. He's a good guy.
Yeah.
I don't know how you know him. Through the photography end of his life, or?
Through his MySpace.com page, and then I interviewed him a while back ago on the air, and he's been helping me out ever since, so.
Okay.
So anyway, back to you. With all the things that you've done in your career, are you ever going to write a book, or have you wrote a book?
No, I haven't. I mean, I'm writing a book, but it's called My Life Story, and it's one that my wife gave me, and it's empty pages. It has a heading like high school years and things like that. So I'm filling in all the blanks. But as far as writing a book about my career, no, I had thought about it, but no, I haven't done that.
Okay, is that something that you might want to do later on in the future?
No, I don't know. It's I'm not real prolific when it comes to the written word, so I'd have to have a co-writer or ghostwriter or whatever you want to call it, somebody to help me out.
Because I'm sure a lot of people, especially the big fans that know a lot about you, maybe not so much up here in the north here, but northern Minnesota, but people who have followed your career for over, ever since you first started doing films, may want to know a lot about you, even if they already know a lot about you. You know what I mean?
So you're in northern Minnesota?
Yeah, we're in a town called Peace River Falls, Minnesota.
Are you near Bemidji?
Yes. We're only like probably 2.5 hours away from Bemidji.
Well, there's another stunt guy that used to be on Kung Fu, and he lives up there in Bemidji. He bought a racetrack when he retired from the business. In fact, he may not be retired. His name is Greg Walker.
Okay.
Greg. I'll look him up. He may even have a website.
I might do that.
He lives in Bemidji, and tell him that Dick Warlock said that he should do an interview with you.
Okay, well, I might just do that. I'll have to do that and see what information I can come up with.
He's on the IMDb, I guess.
Okay.
Everybody is.
Just about everybody.
If you've done one movie, you're on there.
Yeah. Or one screenplay or one little theater extra.
Yeah.
Any up-and-coming project, you mentioned to me before I aired the interview that you recently just got back from a 21-day trip or whatnot, bike trip or something like that?
Yeah. In fact, I was going to go to Bemidji on that bike trip. We left Tennessee and went into Kentucky and then up into Illinois to Chicago. And I was going to go on up to Bemidji and see Greg, but it was just way too far out of the way. So I cut across Nebraska and went down into Colorado and then up to see Crazy Horse. And,
oh, yeah.
All the way over to where Lance lives over in Washington State. Then went down into California and visited my mom and then came on back. And my wife and I, Kathy, she rides on the back with me when I go, and we haul a trailer, and we ride a trike, a going three-wheeler, and that's pretty comfortable.
Oh, yeah, what the heck? Why not, and let's see, a couple more things, what type, you know, with people who, maybe not so much up here, but now, you know, like real close to where you live and whatnot, for anybody that would ever want to be in film or be in a movie or learn how to be a stunt double, what type of advice would you give that person?
Boy, you covered, you know, three different territories here.
Well,
if you're looking to do stunts, I guess there's still jobs out there, but with the CGI, you know, the computer graphics thing, they can take an actor's face and put it on any kind of motion that they want that actor to do. And they're doing it more and more every day. When this first came out, it was very expensive, so it was only in a few films, but now it's getting cheaper to do. So they really have cut a lot of stunt people out of work. But then again, I guess they hired a whole passel of people for the Caribbean movies, and they're working now on the third one. They were shooting simultaneously number two and number three, but they hurry up and finished number two and got it out in the theaters, and now they're going to put the finishing touches on number three, and they used an awful lot of stunt guys on that. But as a rule, there's not as much work for stunt people as there used to be. But there's a lot of work as far as camera, wardrobe, makeup, and all the other fields. And there's an awful lot of non-union productions going, so it's not as essential anymore that you belong to a union like it used to be. Although they prefer that you do, because, the benefits of belonging to a union are much better than when you're without, I can guarantee you that. As far as acting, I don't know a lot about acting other than you need to be prepared when the door is open. I told that to my son Billy when he decided he wasn't going to do stunts any longer. He did stunts for about 6 months, you know. And he said, "Dad, I think I'm going to be an actor." And I said, "Well, I don't know much about that, but I can tell you one thing. When you get in the office, it's a short walk from the front door to the back alley. So you better be ready when the opportunity presents itself. That's called luck." And he studied, not extensively, because he's kind of a natural,
yeah.
You know. But he studied the craft a little bit, and when the opportunity presented itself, he stepped up to the plate and took off. And he's been doing it since he was 18, and he's 45, so he's had a pretty good career.
Yeah.